In this video, we're going to take a look at what is VMware Tanzu for Kubernetes operations. Now, one of the reasons why Kubernetes is so popular is because it gives you a single API to talk to disparate infrastructure endpoints. So development teams, it doesn't really matter to them where that Kubernetes platform is running. All they know is they have to work with a single API, whether that platform runs a cloud provider, where it's running on-prem, etc. And that's the beauty of Kubernetes. However, to build the Kubernetes stack itself on a particular infrastructure provider, it means that the Kubernetes platform needs to have the appropriate drivers, appropriate installation, appropriate building blocks to work with. So for example, if you're deploying a Kubernetes platform on vSphere, then that Kubernetes needs to understand how to work with different infrastructure objects in vSphere, like storage, like networking, etc. Similarly, if you're trying to build one on AWS, then you need to understand what are the different infrastructure parameters that you're going to work with. And accordingly, deploy the corresponding CSI drivers or CNI drivers required for that stack to come up. Now, this is very basic day zero operations, and you need to have the capability of building this consistently, securely, every time somebody needs a Kubernetes cluster. Now, once you have built on a day zero basis this entire Kubernetes stack, that Kubernetes API is pretty powerful when you give it to users. Users who have access to that API can pretty much then start deploying applications. However, they can also start building or creating infrastructure objects needed to support those applications. So for example, they can start provisioning storage volumes, network load balancers, they can create external traffic using those load balancers, etc. So the key is that API is pretty empowering, and we need to protect that API. And so on a day one basis, access to that API needs to be secured. Now, Kubernetes has a role-based access control to that API, but it doesn't have the ability to provide identity services yet. So you need, on a day one basis, from an operations perspective, the ability to map and integrate the Kubernetes RBAC to an identity provider like Active Directory or LDAP that you might have your users logged in. And then, of course, you need a policy that binds all of this together, right? A policy that will say what user has access to what level within Kubernetes. Now, let's say you do that. You create an identity. You bind the Kubernetes RBAC to that identity, to the users, and users are now starting to interact with the Kubernetes API. They are deploying applications. A lot of times, these applications are, there's a lot of unknown to it from an operations perspective. You don't really know where they are going to be downloaded from, or where on the internet was the container image downloaded from, etc. And also, like as I said, that API also gives development teams the capability to create storage volumes, etc. So from a day two perspective, you really want to make sure that you have some baseline security policies applied that determine what gets deployed, how it gets deployed, and what kind of quota is it consuming. So that's something that we need to do on a day two basis. And of course, securing the external traffic, making sure it's, there's TLS for any web traffic, etc. So this is what you'll need to do on a day two basis. And then of course, as development teams start deploying applications, they're consuming a lot of the infrastructure resources. You want to have a capability to monitor everything. What's going on? Where's the traffic coming from? And you need the monitoring capabilities across the stack in terms of metrics, logs, traceability, etc. And then from a day-end basis, you definitely need to have the ability to update the stack when required. Like if there is a new version of Kubernetes or a new version of a driver that the Kubernetes is consuming, you want the ability to automatically upgrade without having major disruptions. So this is what a lot of is involved in running a Kubernetes stack over a period of time. And Tanzu for Kubernetes Operations provides you a lot of these capabilities out of the box. So for example, Tanzu Kubernetes Grid, that is part of Tanzu for Kubernetes Operations, provides you a consistent way of deploying a Kubernetes or bringing up a cluster on a given infrastructure provider of your choice with all the correct drivers and everything necessary to secure that cluster. Then Tanzu Mission Control has the capabilities of, you know, binding that cluster to an identity provider and an RPAC within Kubernetes, and also applying policies around security, like what images get downloaded, what is the pod security policy, what is the network policy, what is the coder policy, etc. So Tanzu management, Tanzu Mission Control actually helps you do that. It helps you manage those clusters. We have Tanzu Service Mesh that, you know, by default, as you enable Tanzu Service Mesh for a cluster, it will enable mutual TLS by default for any services that get created. And we have Tanzu Observability that helps you monitor the entire stack, all the way from applications to infrastructure. Tanzu Mission Control also has the capability of upgrading clusters when required. It will automatically roll out new updates to any existing clusters. So in short, this is what Tanzu Kubernetes Operations looks like. Now let's take a look at how the workflow and the products feel like. Tanzu Mission Control gives you the ability to see all the clusters in a single pane of glass. You can start provisioning Kubernetes clusters using Tanzu Mission Control and Kubernetes Grid to a given cloud provider that you have already added. Once you have the clusters created on a day one basis, you can secure those clusters by providing access, image, network, security, and coder policies using Tanzu Mission Control. This can be done to a fleet of clusters using something called as cluster groups or workspaces. Once you have your clusters and development teams deploying applications, you can centrally monitor every cluster all the way to the infrastructure using Tanzu Observability. You can also add mutual TLS by default to all the services that get created on these clusters and applications using Tanzu Service Mesh. Finally, you can create backups and upgrade a cluster when required or when a patch is made available using Tanzu Mission Control. Thank you.